Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Shout for joy to the Lord, all the earth. Worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. Know that the Lord is God. It is he who made us, and we are his. We are his people, the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving and his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and praise his name. For the Lord is good, and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. And now, let us confess our sins before the Lord. Merciful God, please respond to each of these with forgiveness. Merciful God, for the things we have done that we regret, forgive us. For the things we have failed to do that we regret, forgive us. For all the times we have acted without love, forgive us. For all the times we have reacted without thought, forgive us. For all the times we have withdrawn care, forgive us. For all the times we have failed to forgive, forgive us. For hurtful words said and helpful words unsaid, for unfinished tasks and unfulfilled hopes, God of all time, forgive us and help us to lay down our burden of regret. Amen. To all who turn from sin in sorrow, to all who turn to God in hope, this is God's word of grace. We are accepted. We are forgiven. We are loved. This gift we have from God. Thanks be to God. Amen. And now, please stand and share a reading from your pew as we can be reconciled to God, as we reconcile to one another. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Please share. Please join me in prayer for illumination. Lord God, help us to know your ways. Teach us your paths, lead us in your truth, and teach us, for you are the God of our salvation. For you we wait all day long, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our first reading this morning is from the book of Exodus, chapter 33, verses 12 through 23. Moses said to the Lord, "See, you have said to me, bring up this people. But you have not let me know whom you will send with me. You have said, I know you by name, and you have also found favor in my sight. Now, if I have found favor in your sight, show me your ways, so that I may know you and find favor in your sight. Consider too that this nation is your people." He said, "My presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." And he said to him, "If your presence will not go, do not carry us up from here. For how shall it be known that I have found favor in your sight, I and your people, unless you go with Moses said, "Show me your glory, I pray." And the Lord said, "I will lay all my goodness cast before you, and will proclaim before you the name the Lord. And I will be gracious to whom I will be gracious, and will show mercy on whom I will show mercy. But," said the Lord, "you cannot see my face, for no one shall see me and live." And the Lord continued, "See, there is a place by me where you shall stand on the rock. And while my glory passes by, I will put you in a cleft of the rock, and I will stand over you with my hand and cover you until I have passed by. Then I will take away my hand, and you shall see my back, but my face shall not be seen." Our second reading today is from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 22, verses 15 through 22. Then the Pharisees went and plotted to entrap Jesus in what he said. So they sent their disciples to him, along with the Herodians, saying, "Teacher, we know that you are sincere and teach the way of God in accordance with the truth, and show deference to no one, for we do not regard people with partiality. Tell us then what you think. Is it lawful to pay taxes to the emperor or not?" But Jesus, aware of their malice, said, "Why are you putting me to the test? Show me the coin used for the tax." And they brought him the denarius. Then he said to them, "Whose head and whose title?" They answered, "The emperor's." Then Jesus said to them, "Give therefore to the emperor the things that are the emperor's, and to God the things that are God's." When they heard this, they were amazed, and they left him and went away. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Good morning.
Good morning.
A little weird this morning, a little different, but that's okay. We're rolling with the differences. I think I know that some of you, when you hear this story from the Gospels, that your pastor is about to pitch you a stewardship sermon. More to the point, you might be thinking, he's going to ask us for money soon, isn't he? I am your pastor. This is what I do. And this is a stewardship sermon of sorts. But it's not the one where I ask people The Israelites didn't know where Moses was. They couldn't feel God's presence. They wondered if God had abandoned them. In their panic, the Israelites went to Aaron, Moses' brother, and they asked him to make an image of God, an idol to which they could pray and offer sacrifices. You remember this from last Sunday, right? Even though God had just told them not to do it, it almost didn't matter. And, as you may recall from last Sunday, or from years from the new church, God was angry. Very, very angry. Moses had to bargain with God. He had to plead with God and remind God of all the promises that God had made. He had to change the subject of the conversation from wrath to relationship. He had to remind God of the special relationship with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Jacob, who was renamed Israel after struggling with God. God made a promise to Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, and all of their children, that God would always be faithful, even when the Israelites were unfaithful. God would always keep the faith. When we pick up the story this morning, Moses is still bargaining with God. You see, God had been going before Moses and the Israelites. And in his anger, God was going to withdraw from the scene. And instead, he was going to send an angel before Moses and the Israelites. The angel would lead the way to the promised land, not God. That wasn't good enough for Moses. Moses wanted and needed to know that God was leading the way. Moses needed to be able to tell the Israelites that God was in charge. He knew they needed that piece of reassurance. So Moses asked for one more thing, one more blessing. He asked to see God's glory. In other words, he asked to see the face of God. And if you're old enough, you'll catch the reference, I can almost hear Columbo say, one more thing about it. This idea of asking God for one more thing, that's what my Jewish friends would call chutzpah. It's a lot to ask to see God's face. And what's more, no mortal is able to see God's face and live. Another word for this is audacity. And let's face it, Moses needed that audacity, that chutzpah, to lead the Israelites through the wilderness all those years. We are like the Israelites in so many ways. We may not complain quite as much. We don't blame God for every little difficulty we encounter, though sometimes we blame others for the problems that we create. I think we have a greater sense of agency Israelites, we are not yet where we want to be. We kind of know we can't go back to the old ways of doing things, but we don't know when we'll arrive at our new destination. We feel like we're on an endless journey. It's exhausting. And we want to see God's glory. We need to know where we're going. We need audacity. We need chutzpah. Now, here's the good news. God fulfills God's promises. Always. Even when Moses makes a ridiculous request, God grants that request. Why? Because God is always faithful to God's promises. Of course, God allows Moses to bargain with God. That's a sign that Moses and the Israelites are going to re-engage with the relationship they have with God. They're going to re-engage in the relationship between God and God's chosen people. By bargaining, Moses is showing that the people are ready to return to their relationship and to their covenant with God. We are gathered here this morning to celebrate the sacrament of baptism. In that sacrament, we reaffirm our covenantal relationship with God. We reaffirm that we are all God's beloved children and that we have a relationship with God. In return, we get to see the glory of God's face in adoration and prayer. And all the other young ones in our midst. I know that some of the other parents in this congregation might not agree that we are always seeing God's grace in the face of their children. No names. But it's true. That is where we see God's glory. In the baptismal liturgy that we are about to engage in, we will proclaim and affirm our covenant with God. We live into that covenant by preserving and strengthening and growing this congregation. We live into that covenant by doing the work of spirit to keep this church is one body and one spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. At this point, I would invite the audience to come forward, and our esteemed clerk of session. Obeying the word of our Lord Jesus Christ and confident of his promises, we baptize those whom God has called. In baptism, God claims us and seals us to show that we belong to God. God frees us from sin and death, uniting us with Jesus Christ in his death and resurrection. By water and the Holy Spirit, we are made members of the church, the body of Christ, and joined to Christ's ministry of love, peace, and justice. Let us remember with joy our own baptism as we celebrate this sacrament.
On behalf of the session, I present Evelyn Clare, daughter of Joseph and Emily Whitmer, to receive the sacramental baptism.
Emily and Joe, putting your whole trust in the grace and love of Jesus Christ, do you desire Evelyn Clare to be baptized? Will you be responsible for nurturing Evelyn Clare in the faith and the life of the Christian community? To you, our Lord Jesus Christ ordered us to teach those who are baptized to obey all that I have commanded. Do you, the people of this church, promise to tell this child the good news of the gospel and to help her know all that Christ commands, and by our love and fellowship to strengthen her family ties with the household of God? Do you?
We do.
Please join me in the affirmation of belief. With the whole church, let us confess our faith. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son of the Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, who suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried.
He descended to the dead.
On the third day he rose again.
He ascended into heaven.
And he is at the right hand of God.
He will come again to judge the living and the dead.
Do you believe in God, the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
To give our thanks and praise.
Blessed are you, gracious God, creator of the universe, ruler of heaven and earth. You are the source of life and life for all creation. In your goodness, you give us the sign of water.
Glory to you forever and ever.
We give you thanks, eternal God, for you nourish and sustain all living things by the gift of water. In the beginning of time, your spirit moved over the watery chaos, calling forth order and life. In the time of Noah, you destroyed evil by the waters of the flood, giving righteousness a new beginning. You led Israel out of slavery through the waters of the sea and into the freedom of the promised land. In the waters of Jordan, Jesus was baptized by John and anointed with your spirit. By the baptism of his own death and resurrection, Christ set us free from sin and death and opened the way to eternal life. We thank you, O God, for the water of baptism. In it we are buried with Christ in his death. From it we are raised to share in his resurrection. Through it we are reborn by the power of the Holy Spirit. Send your Spirit to move over this water, that it may be a fountain of deliverance and rebirth. Wash away the sin of all who are cleansed by it. Raise them to new life and graft them to the body of Christ. Pour out your living Holy Spirit upon them, that they may have the power to do your will and continue forever in the risen life of Christ. To you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, we all praise, honor, and glory, now and forever. Amen.
Hello.
I have this effect. Please join me. With joy and thanksgiving, we welcome you into Christ's church, for we are all one in Christ. We promise to share the good news of the gospel with you and help you know and follow Christ. Amen. Welcome, Adam, here. Welcome to the family. So this is normally the time I would ask you for money, but This week, Betsy lost her mother, Louise. She had been in hospice, and Betsy did get the call and say goodbye. And Betsy seems to be in good place with all this, but still, prayers for her in this time of loss. Losing a parent is just never, it's never easy, no matter how expected it is. We lift up Carol Morris's sister, Leva, who is having some serious health problems at this time. We pray for healing and wellness for Leva, and that she find God's light and love in this time. This morning, we also lift up Beth and Bev, Marley, Pat, and Sophie, Betty and Karen, Bobby, Eileen, Pat, Gwyneth, and Marie, and Joseph, Ella, Kyle, Patsy, and Bob, Matthew, and Heather. God, we lift all of these people up in care. We ask that you shine a light in their darkness, and again, direct us to bear that light into the darkness. To live into the covenant that we have with you, love one another as you have loved us. We do all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who taught us to pray to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Now, beloved, as you go forth into the world, remember that God is always faithful. Remember that we have promises to keep to God.